Hi everyone and welcome to this video. My name is Greg and today I'm going to be showing you how to make a website for your restaurant in the shortest amount of time and with no technical skills. So you can get really in depth on how to make a website, but in this tutorial I'm going to try to keep it under 10 minutes and walk you through the majority of how to make the website so you can make a basic website for your restaurant today. So without further ado, let's get right into the computer. So the first thing to talk about is we're going to be using a website builder. The website builder we're going to use is called Wix. Wix is one of the biggest website builders, so it's a really good option to use. Now, if you don't use a website builder, you have to hire a programmer, someone who's going to manually code your website. This is extremely expensive, time-consuming, and if you want to update your menu or update your location and phone number, you have to contact the programmer and they have to change it from their back end. Using a website builder like this, you can change anything on your website and push it to your live website instantly in a few clicks of a button, and you don't need any technical skills. So this is Wix right here, it's wix.com. Now I've used so many of the website builders out there and I've even paid programmers to make websites, but I know that if you're making a basic website for your restaurant and you need it something easy, Wix is the best option. So with that being said, I'm actually affiliated with Wix on this video, so you can use my sign up link and it gives me credit down the road for you signing up using the link. So if you wanna just go to wix.com and sign up there, no problem. But if you type in this link right up top, it actually gives me credit down the road. I'm gonna link this in the description, so if you wanna use it, feel free. If not, you can just go to wix.com and follow along there. So I'm gonna go through as if you were to use my link. So this is going to bring you to my link, and it's the same thing as what we just saw before, but it just gives me credit. So you can either hit start now here, or you can hit get started here. Both will just bring you to creating an account and choosing your template. So I'm gonna hit get started right here. And then it's gonna ask us to log in or sign up. So if you already have a Wix account, you can log in right here. If you don't, just hit sign up and you can set an email address and a password and it'll bring you right to the same place. So I set this example here, I'm just gonna use that and go ahead and log in. And then we don't have a website yet, so it's gonna say create your first website. We'll just hit that right there. And it's gonna ask what kind of business we are, just to point us in the right direction of templates. So we're gonna use restaurants and food. And then if you want to change that at all, you can come down to this side over here and you can go even more specific or a different category. Just look at all the templates. I'm actually going to go down to restaurant and we'll do that right there. And now you can scroll through all of these templates and you can choose whatever one you'd like to use. So what I suggest you do is go and view these. So you can pause this video here in about 30 seconds, but what you'll do is go through, see which one you like, and then just hit view on it. Instead of edit, you can view it just to kind of try it out and see what it would look like. So if you hit view, you can see what this website would look like if you were to customize it as your own. And then if you like it, you can hit edit this site. If you don't, you can close out of that tab or just go back to the other tab and it'll bring you back to exactly where we were. So I'm actually going to go with this template. So this is the one that I just chose before and I'm gonna go ahead and hit edit this site. So you can pause the video and you can find a template that you like here. So now we are in the Wix editor. This is where we can actually edit things to customize it to our own website. I know this is going a little bit quickly, but this can go really in depth and take a long time. I have a full Wix tutorial that I've made that goes into detail on what all of these buttons do. I'm gonna link that down in the description as well. So after this tutorial, you can watch that one if you want more details on what all these buttons do. But also remember, as you're going through this tutorial, if you have any questions, you can leave them down in the comments and I'll get back to you. I'm always checking it and I can help you out there. But the first thing we're gonna do here is just adjust the name that's in this corner. So what you can do is double click that and you can actually start typing. So if your restaurant name was Taco Crazy, that would be a cool restaurant name. You can just type in Taco Crazy right there. Now, if you have specific colors or specific fonts that you use, double click that, you can change the font right here, change it to whatever you like. You can change the size, the color, everything right there. Or if you have a logo already made, what we're gonna do is just click this once and actually hit the backspace or delete button on your keyboard. That's going to take that out completely. No text, we're gonna go over to add. We'll go to image and then my image uploads. Now, I don't have a logo ready for this, so I'm actually just going to pick a photo of me. This will be pretty funny, but I'm gonna put that in as our logo. So all we have to do for that is hit upload media and choose our computer, that's where the file is, and then select the item that you wanna upload. This is hopefully your logo file. And it might prompt you with something here. If that's the case, just X out of that. And then all we have to do is hit add to page. Now, once this is here, this is our logo right here. So I'm just going to make it smaller just so it fits in this white area up here. And then I'm gonna drag it right in. And if it fits all the way in, you see how the blue borders are within the white here? It's going to turn that header orange, and that's actually going to allow us to add it to the header. So let me show you what that means. Add it to header, okay, got it. Now if we were to preview the site, we can see that that's in the header and it stays up there. It doesn't go away as we scroll past it. That's perfect. That's where you want your logo to stay. You want your header and all your menu options to be up top here as people scroll through your site. We'll go back to edit here, and then we're gonna come down and we're going to change the name here. So you want this to be the name of your restaurant or the main food item that you serve. As you can see, this template has the name of the restaurant and then what kind of food they serve. This is perfect. So I'm just gonna change this to Taco Crazy. Now, if you run into an issue like this, you can select all of that text and you can actually make it a bit smaller. And then when you click off, you should have your text right there and you don't get any weird formatting. And if at any point you mess up and you wanna go back, you can hit this back button right here and it'll undo the changes, or you can go forward and redo the changes that you just made. I'm gonna go ahead and just leave this Mexican cuisine how it is, and I'm going to address the three buttons here. This is actually really good for a restaurant. It's a small landing page, so it'll load really quickly, and then people have the main options that you want them to do. Menu, order online, or make a reservation. Now you can adjust these by clicking on this and then change text. So if you wanted that to say view menu, you could change it to view, just like that. And then you can make sure that it's linking to your menu page. So you have the dropdown of all the pages that come by standard on this template, and you can make sure it's linking to your menu page. Once that's done, just make sure it's in current window so it's not taking them somewhere else. Hit done, and that's all you have to adjust there. Now, like I said, this tutorial is going extremely fast. So if you are getting lost at all, just know that you can leave a comment below and I will help you out there. Or you can watch the full tutorial that'll go through step by step, just explaining everything slower and in more detail. But I did want to make this tutorial at a swift pace so I'm not wasting your time, and you can use the pause button along the way if you need to slow down a little bit. So with that being said, we're going to scroll back up to the top and we're going to come to this little drop down here. This is how you navigate from different pages. As you can see, you can't click it right now in editor. If you want to be able to click that, you have to hit preview, and then you can navigate to different pages. But we're not gonna use that. We're gonna stay in editor and we're going to hit the drop down and come down to the different pages here. So what we're gonna do is just go along all these pages and edit it, fill it out with our own information. So we'll hit our story right here. This is the about page. So what we're going to do is switch this to the name of your restaurant. So we're gonna hit Taco Crazy story, and then we'll scroll down here and we can change all this information to fit our restaurant. Now, a cool little trick I wanna show you is, see there's no text over here? If you wanna add text and you want it to look exactly like this, without wasting time, you can click this one once, you can hold shift and click the one below it, and then you can copy it. So right click, copy, come down over here, click once, and then right click again and paste it. Now it'll paste that exact thing right over here and you can drag it. Now you can start customizing it there, and then it'll save you a lot of time. So we're just going to do this on all of the pages until the information is customized how we like it. So what about the photos? This is one of the most important parts of the website, and you wanna make sure that they match what your restaurant stands for. So what we're gonna do is just click on this background here. Make sure you're not selecting a text or anything like that. Click on the background once, and then we'll hit change strip background here. And we can do settings to adjust how the photo looks, or we can switch the image entirely. Now, a little thing I wanna show you just for using Wix Website Builder is you can actually go to free from Wix, and now you have a bunch of free professional stock photos that you can choose from in case you don't have any professional ones taken of your own restaurant. So if we type in taco, we can see that we have some stock photos of tacos that we could choose from right here. So I'm gonna go ahead and choose this one right here, and then we'll just hit change background. And now you can see that it changed that background to this new photo here. Now, if this text is kind of blending in, you see how it's white text on a light white background? All you have to do is hit settings on the photo. And then right at the top, you have image opacity. So just change that from that kind of ruby red color to a black, and then drag this image opacity down to like 60. Now you can see, you can read the text again, just like that. So we can X out of that, and we're almost done with our site already. So I want to change the address down here. Make sure that you just double click that and type in the actual address of your restaurant. This way people can easily find you. They can click that address and pull it up in Maps. And then the other thing is double click over here and change Madre to the name of your restaurant. And then you can delete Proudly Created by Wix, because you might not want to display that on your site. Now, a little fun fact for you is, just by you creating this website by hand, you actually own the copyright to it. So that's what this copyright symbol is right here. And you put the year that you created this, and that way you're protected by simple copyright. Easy as that. And then only a couple more things on this template. As you can see, there is a social bar up top. So we can click on that and we can do settings, and then you can come down to settings. And you can actually remove ones that you don't have, or you could turn on ones that you do have, and then you can set the links to link to those profiles. Easy as that, and that way you're socially connected, so if people want to see your Facebook page or your Yelp page, they can easily click it right here. Now, we're basically wrapped up already here. Just go through here and change out your photos, change out your text, make everything custom to your restaurant, and then you can hit publish. Now our website is live on the internet, just like that. We have a free website on the internet. Now the only stipulation to this is if we hit view site, it'll bring us to that website, but as you can see, it has Wix branding on it. So it's not really all your website. It still says Wix in the domain name, the URL, and then it also still has the Wix branding throughout. So if you want to make this entirely your own website, all you have to do is hit upgrade right here, compare plans, and then you can see the different plans. You pay a couple dollars per month and the website is entirely yours. So it's going to bring you to the business plans, but if you stuck around this far in the video, I think you deserve this. You can come right over to website and you can actually get cheaper plans. So what I recommend is the unlimited plan. It's gonna give you everything you need, customize it to be exactly your own website. It won't say anything about Wix, and you'll be set for only $7 a month. You don't need to use a big business plan for this. If you want to, feel free. There's a couple options, like you can accept payments online, but if you're just making reservations and not processing payments on your website, if you just have people pay when they get to the restaurant, you can use an unlimited plan like this and you'll have everything you need. So guys, if you've made it this far in the tutorial, everything is basically done. If you want a slower, more detailed tutorial of how to use Wix to build your own website, I'm gonna link that down in the description so you can watch that on a little bit slower pace and learn all the small things. This was a quick tutorial, so if you have any questions, leave them down in the comments and I'll get back to you with an answer to help you out and put this site together. So with that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this website. I'm looking forward to you having your own restaurant's website. If you have any questions, let me know and I will see you guys in the next one.